വക്രതുണ്ടമഹാകായ സൂര്യകോടിസമപ്രഭ നിർവിഘ്നം കുരുമേ ദേവ സർവകാര്യേഷു സർവദാ സരസ്വതിവസ്തുഭ്യം വരദേ കാമരൂപിണി വിദ്യാരംഭം കരിഷ്യാമി സിദ്ധിർഭവതു മേ സദാ. ഗുരവേ സർവലോകാനാം വിഷയേ ഭവരോഗിനാം നിധയേ സർവവിദ്യാനാം ദക്ഷിണാമൂർത്തയേ നമഃ. ഈശ്വരോ ഗുരുരാത്മേതി മൂർത്തിഭേദവിഭാഗിനേ വ്യോമവദ്വ്യാപ്തദേഹായ ദക്ഷിണാമൂർത്തയേ നമഃ. ശ്രുതിസ്മൃതിപുരാണാനാം ആലയം കരുണാലയം നമാമി ഭഗവത്പാദം ശങ്കരം ലോകശങ്കരം. സദാശിവസമാരംഭാം ശങ്കരാചാര്യമധ്യമാം അസ്മദാചാര്യപര്യന്താം വന്ദേ ഗുരുപരമ്പരാം. സാക്ഷാത് കൃതം ദയാനന്ദം പരമാർത്ഥസ്വരൂപിണം തത്വജ്ഞാനപ്രശാസ്താരം പ്രണതോസ്മി പരം പദം. ഓം സഹനാഭവതു സഹനൗ ഭുനക്തു സഹവീര്യം കരവാവഹൈ തേജസ്വിനാവധീതമസ്തു മാ വിദ്വിഷാവഹൈ. ഓം ശാന്തി ശാന്തി ശാന്തിഃ. ഓം പാർത്ഥായ പ്രതിബോധിതാം ഭഗവതാ നാരായണേന സ്വയം വ്യാസേന ഗ്രഥിതാം പുരാണമുനിനാ മധ്യേ മഹാഭാരതം അദ്വൈതാമൃതവർഷിണീം ഭഗവതീം അഷ്ടാദശാധ്യായിനീം അമ്പത്വാമനുസന്ദധാമി ഭഗവത്ഗീതേ ഭവദ്വേഷിണീം. നമോസ്തു തേ വ്യാസവിശാലബുദ്ധേ ഉല്ലാരവിന്ദായ തപത്രനേത്ര യേന ത്വയാ ഭാരതതൈലപൂർണഃ പ്രജ്വാലിതോ ജ്ഞാനമയഃ പ്രദീപഃ. പ്രപന്നപാരിജാതായ തോത്രവേത്രൈകഭാണയേ ജ്ഞാനമുദ്രായ കൃഷ്ണായ ഗീതാമൃതദുഹേ നമഃ. സർവോപനിഷദോ ഗാവഃ ദുഗ്ധാ ഗോപാലനന്ദനഃ പാർത്ഥോ വത്സഃ സുധീർഭോക്താ ദുഗ്ധം ഗീതാമൃതം അഗത്. വസുദേവസുതം ദേവം കംസചാണൂരമർദനം ദേവകീ പരമാനന്ദം കൃഷ്ണം വന്ദേ ജഗദ്ഗുരും. ഭീഷ്മദ്രോണതടാ ജയദ്രഥജലാ ഗാന്ധാരനീലോത്പലാ ശല്യഗ്രാഹവതീ കൃപേണ വഹനീ കർണേന വേലാകുലാ അശ്വത്ഥാമ വികർണ ഘോരമകരാ ദുര്യോധനാവർത്തിനീ സോത്തീർണാ ഖലു പാണ്ഡവേന നളദീ കൈവർത്തക കേശവഃ. పారాశర్యవచసరోజమవలం గీతార్థగంధోత్కటం నానాఖ్యానకకేసరం హరికథాసంబోధనాబోధితం లోకే సజ్జన షట్పదైరఘరగః పేపీయమానం ముదా భూయాద్ భారత పంకజం కలిమల ప్రధ్వంసిన శ్రేయసే మూకం కరోతి వాచాలం పంగుం లంఘయతే గిరిం యత్కృపాత్తమహం వందే పరమానందమాధవం యం బ్రహ్మా వరుణేంద్ర రుద్ర మరుతః స్తున్వంతి దివ్యైస్తవైః వేదైః సాంగపదక్రమోపనిషదైః గాయంతి యం సామగాః ధ్యానావస్థిత తద్గతేన మనసా పశ్యంతి యం యోగినః యస్యాంతం న విదుస్సురాసురగణాః దేవాయ తస్మై నమః నారాయణం నమస్కృత్య నరం చైవ నరోత్తమం దేవీం సరస్వతీం వ్యాసం తతో జయముదీరయేత్. You can repeat after me. Shloka number 16, second chapter, 16th shloka. Nasato vidyate bhavah.
Nasato vidyate bhavah.
Na bhavo vidyate satah.
Bhavo vidyate satah.
ఉభయోరపి దృష్టోంతః
ఉభయోరపి దృష్టోంతః
అనయోస్తత్వదర్శిభిః
అనయోస్తత్వదర్శిభిః
అవినాశితు తద్విద్ధి సర్వమిదం తతం వినాశమవ్యయస్యాస్య న కశ్చిత్ కర్తుమర్హతి17th shloka. We have seen in the previous class the outline. Then next shloka. Before the next shloka, we will read the sangati, the connection to the next shloka. Kim punaha.
Kim punaha.
Tat asat.
స్వాత్మసత్తాన్వ్యభిచరతి
ఇత్యుచ్యతే. కిం పునః తత్ అసత్ యత్ స్వాత్మసత్తాం విభిచరతి ఇత్యుచ్యతే ఇతి ఉచ్యతే. వాట్ ఇస్ సత్? సతః అభావః న విద్యతే. అండ్ వాట్ ఇస్ దట్ సత్? వాట్ ఇస్ దట్ సత్ వాస్ టాక్డ్ అబౌట్ ఇన్ ది ప్రీవియస్ శ్లోక, దట్ ఈస్ 17th శ్లోక. And now, what is asat? What is asat is talked about in the 18th shloka. And in the 16th shloka, we saw Bhagavan introduced asat and sat. For that, the sangati was, why shoka moha should not be done? With regard to Sita, Ushna, etc., Sita, Ushna, the Sakanam, that enduring Sita, Ushna, the without experiencing shoka moha, why it should be done? For that, Bhagavan told what is sat and what is asat. For that reason, shoka moha na karaniyam, na karani yaniti bhagavata uttam. And in the 17th shloka, asat sat was talked about vinashitu tadviddi. And in this shloka, asat is talked about kim punaha, what again, kim tat asat, what is that asat? It vyabhicharati sat na vyabhicharati asat vyabhicharati, because sataha abhavaha vidyate asataha bhavaha na vidyate. So therefore sat na vyabhicharati asat vyabhicharati kim tat asat yat svatma sattam vyabhicharati, that asat which changes from its own being, own state, which loses its being, vibhicharati, svatma sattam vibhicharati, which changes, that which changes, that is called asat. That is being talked about in this shloka, 18th shloka. We will read the shloka. Antavanta ime deha.
Antavanta ime deha.
Nityasyokta sharirinah. Anashino prameyasya. Tasmad yudhyasva bharata. Antavantaha, antavantaha, ime dehaha, nityasya, uktaha, shadirinaha, anashinaha, aprameyasya, avagrahayasya, anashino prameyasya, anashinaha, aprameyasya, tasmat, yudhyasva, yudhyasva is the kriyapadam, yudhyasva, lot, lakara. Madhyama Purusha Ekavachanam Yudhyasva Yudhyatam Yudhyetam Yudhyantam Yudhyasva. So Madhyama Purusha Ekavachanam Yudhyasva Tasmat Yudhyasva Bharata. Bharata is Sambodhana. So Nityasya Sharirinaha Anashinaha Apremeyasya ime dehaha antavantaha. Tasmat he bharata yudhyasva. Sharirinaha means sharire vartate. Shariraha asya asti. That which has body, that is called shariri. Sharirin shabda, nakaranta shabda. Shariram asya asti. Like dehin, dehi we say. Degaha asya asti ti dehin. Dehi, dehinau, dehinaha. Similarly, shariri, sharirinau, sharirinaha. But this sharirinaha is shashti bhakti, ekavachanam. Karin shabdavat. It is not pratama bhakti, bhagavachanam. Antavantaha is there. Dehaha is there. Dehaha is Bhagavachanam. Ime is the ayam emo ime, that is also Pullinga. Ayam idam idam shabdasya rupam pratama vyakti bhagavachanam. So ime dehaha sharinaha sharinaha, we cannot take it as pratama vyakti bhagavachanam. Then that comes a contradiction. Shariri means that which has a body, the indweller of the body, not shariram. Deha means shariram. So dehaha sharirana, they cannot be in samanadikaranyam. If you think pratama vibhakti bhagavachanam, that sharirana, then becomes a problem. Ime dehaha sharirana, no. Sharirana is shashti vibhakti ekavachanam. Ime dehaha pratama vibhakti bhagavachanam. Sharirana, that doesn't have antavat. Antavat. Antavantaha means that which has end. You'll be seeing, Bhagavad-pada will be seeing later. Antavantaha means that which is subject to destruction. Antavantaha. That is Bhagavachanam. Sharirinaha and Antavantaha cannot go because Vachanam mismatches that. Dehaha Antavantaha. Ime Dehaha Antavantaha. This Deha, Sharir, these bodies have the nature of subject to destruction. Sharirani Nashvarani, that is the meaning. Bodies are perishable. They are not real. They are mithya. What we call body doesn't exist really. A body is nothing but it is put together. We cannot point out and say this is the body. What is the body? Is this the structure, the skeletal structure, or the majja, the bone, or the asti, or it is a blood, or is a gene? So what do you call this body? Really speaking, the body is put together, like a car is put together. A car has more than 700 parts. You cannot call a carburetor or an engine as a car. It is only an engine. When all the parts are put together, then only car comes to being. An individual part is not called a car. But everything, when everything is put together, it becomes a car. A car can be driven, but not the individual parts. Similarly, the body is also intelligently put together. We cannot call any parts of the body as this body, as the body. A hand cannot be the body. A hand once amputated from the body, it doesn't belong to the body. We call it as a hand. We don't call it as a body. So therefore the body has parts, avayavas. And these avayavas are intelligently put together, assembled to give a certain form and a certain function. Individually, they may perform certain function. As a whole, they perform certain function. As a whole only, the individual can also perform certain function, provided life is there. Therefore, this body is what is created. It is assembled. It's an assemblage. Because it is an assemblage, because it has avayavas, because they are put together, therefore, it is a product, a karyam. Therefore, karyatvat tasya vikaraha bhavati. It is subject to modification. Shat vikaras. Asti, jayate, vartate, viparinavate, apakshiyate, and finally, death, apakshiyate, maranam. That is the end of the body. Everybody perishes. So, nashashilam, idam shariram, nashashilam. Ime degaha, antavantaha. What is a hetu? Karyatvat. Because of being a karya, therefore, degaha, antavantaha. A product is always put together and therefore subject to change. And this body is called Shariram because it is put together, and therefore it perishes. It is subject to destruction. A body is called Shariram. If you see the Vyutpatti, why it is called Shariram? Kshiryamanatvat Shariram, which is subject to decay, destruction. That is why it is called Shariram. Body has got another name also, Deha. Dahana Yogyatvat Deha. It is eligible for cremation. Therefore, it is called Deha. So, Ime Deha. Therefore, Ime Deha Antavantaha. And how many Degas are there? Anekaha Bhagavacham. Because there are many, many Jivas, because there are many and varied. Therefore, Bhagavachanam, and therefore they are Asat. Only Asat are many. Sat cannot be many. Therefore, Bhagavachanam is used Asat. And what is this Shariram? This Shariram is Annamayam, a product of Annam. What is Annam? What is Ashitam? What is eaten is called Annam. What is eaten has become Annam. And this Ashitam Annam Tridha Vibhajyate. It divides into three parts. When the eaten food is divided into three parts. Stulaha, Madhyamaha, Sukshmaha iti. Tridha Parinamate. It undergoes three changes, becomes three different things. Stula, Sukshma, Madhyama. Eaten food is converted into three parts. One is gross, other one is madhyama, in between, other one is subtle. And what happens to the gross part? Bhuktasya annasya rupam stula bhaga. Bhuktasya annasya stula bhaga, that gross portion, malam bhavati. Purisham bhavati. That becomes the malam, the excreta. Therefore, bhagihi agachati. Malarupena, Shrirat. And what is Madhyama? That becomes Mamsam. Yata Madhyamaha Tata Mamsam Bhavati. Yaha Madhyamaha Tata Mamsam Bhavati. Like Rakta Mamsa, Medha, Asti, Majja, Girya, Rupena, Parinamate. Whereas Sukshma, the subtle parts, the subtle Sukshmaha, Anishtaha, that Anu, the subtle parts, that Dhatuhu, Manaha Bhavati. That becomes the mind. Therefore, everything is a product. The Shariram, Stula Shariram, Sukshma Shariram, Karana Shariram, we say, and these different Pancha Kosha. So all these are nothing but the product. Therefore, the body is perishable, Antavantaha. That is a known thing. We know that body is perishable. Then, therefore, how can it be Satyam? If it is perishable, then how can it be Satyam? But we take it as a Satyam, and therefore we give so much reality to this body, thinking that it is going to be there forever. That is because this Shariram is given existence, the Shariram is given the Chaitanyam, the consciousness, by Atma. That Sat Vastu, that renders Satta to the body. Therefore, Shariram is dependent on Atma. Shariram, for its living, for its being, it depends on Atma. Depends on Atma, the Sat Vastu, for its existence. Therefore, Shariram as its being in Atma, Atma only. And Atma is it subject to destruction? No, Atma is Amaraha. Atma, Atmanaha Nashakana Vidyate. Kalatrayepi Tasya Nashakana Bhavati. Atmanaha Nashakana Bhavati. Bodies are many. Bodies are many. That is why here plural, ime degaha, it is used. bodies are many because there are many, therefore they are limited, they are finite, whereas atma is one, therefore sharirinaha ekavachanam is used. Sharirinaha ime dehaha antavantaha. Antavantaha. Antavantaha means nashavantaha. Antaha vidyate eshamte antavantaha. Nashavantaha. That which has destruction. For which there is destruction, it is called antavantaha. The one which has subject to end, but is called antavantaha. Ime degaha, sharirinaha ime degaha antavantaha. That is, for the Atma, which is only one, which resides, which is there, for because of which the body is, that doesn't have destruction. These many bodies, ime degaha, these many bodies, which is the residence of that only one Atma, are subject to destruction. The bodies are subject to destruction. So what does it mean? It means Atma is only one. What is there is only one. Because subject-object division is there, that is negated by saying Ekam Satyam. Atma is only one. And that cannot be destroyed. That is second one. Second point. That cannot be destroyed. Anashinaha. And Shariams are many. And therefore, destructible. Antavantaha. Iti. Shariram is Anityaha. Therefore, Antavantaha. Destructible. Atma is Nityaha, therefore Nityasya Sharirinaha. Nityasya Sharirinaha. That Atma which is Nityam, Atma is Nityaha. Nityasya Sarvada Ekarupasya Sharirinaha Shariravataha Atmanaha Ime Degaha Antavantaha. Always that Nitya Atma. Always it is ekarupaha. Sarvada ekarupasya sharirinaha. Sharirinaha is shariravataha. That which has shariram. It is called sharirinaha. Shariraha asya asti. That is one. Shariravat, another pratyaya is shariravataha. Therefore, these bodies, since these bodies are subject to destruction, therefore antavatvat prameyaha prameyatvat nashi. Atma is aprameyaha, not available for objectification. It is not an object, whereas the body is prameyaha. It is available for objectification, available for pratyakshadi pramanam. Therefore, anatma prameyaha, atma aprameyaha. Therefore, aprameyasya nityasya atmanaha, all are in the same vibhakti, samanadhikaranyam. Therefore, the atma which is aprameya and which is nitya, which is permanent. And here in this shloka, you can see two words signifying the same thing are used. One is Nityasya. Nityasya means permanent. Anashinaha is that which is not subject to destruction. That is also permanent only. Nashaha vidyate yasya, that which is not subject to destruction. Anashinaha. That which is subject to destruction is antamantaha, that is related to anatma shariram. Here, nityasya anashinaha, these two words, they signify the same thing. Is there any differences between the two words, or is it the same thing? If it is the same thing, then it becomes a punarukti dosha. Punaruktihi. It becomes a punarukti, the repetition. Therefore, it cannot be the same thing. There is a difference. The difference is that between Nitya, Nityasya and Anashinaha. What is the difference? If a person or a thing can undergo destruction, can undergo vinasha, can undergo vinasha in either relatively or permanently. A thing or a person can have vinasha either relatively or permanently. For example, a person has some disease, a serious disease, a terminal disease. Then we say the person is almost finished by the disease. There is no hope of regaining health or coming back to its original state. It is not possible because the disease is terminal, is approaching death. Therefore, we say the person almost dead. His death is nearing. Therefore, we say he is finished. His life is going to end. Therefore, figuratively, we say he is dead. But the person is alive. Yes, he is not dead yet. He lives. Maybe another 1 week he will live, but still we say he is dead. And another type of destruction is there, where the person really dies. Prana has left the body and now the body is ready to be cremated. Then we say he is dead. And what is the difference between these two sentences, he is dead? One is relative. One is relative, another one is the fact. The person is dead, has gone away. So these are the two types of destruction. Two types of destruction, relatively and permanently, we say using the words he is dead. It can mean two different types of destruction. Since there are two types of destruction, relative and permanent, therefore two words are used, nityasya and anashinaha. Therefore it is not punaruktihi. Bhagavad Pada himself will say, what is the difference? Why do we say nityasya? Why Bhagavan says nityasya anashinaha? Nityasya and anashinaha. Because there are two types of destruction, therefore to negate the two types of destruction, to emphasize, to say that the Atma is not subject to either relative or permanent destruction, therefore two words are used. Iti Bhagavad Pada himself will say in his Bhashyam, you will be seeing. And here in this shloka, using different words, Bhagavan Krishna, he describes Asat. Asat is Prameya. Prameya means that which can be known. That is called Prameya. That which is available for objectification, that is called Prameya. That is from the Dhatu Ma Dhatu. Ma means to measure. Ma means to measure, to fathom. With Pra Upasarga becomes Prameya. Prameya, that which is available for objectification, that which can be known. Nyeya vastu. Nyeyam, prameyam, it's an object of knowledge. Prama is knowledge. Pramata is knower. Pramanam is the means of knowledge. So for the knowledge of anything, you need pramanam. You need pramanam to know the prameya vastu. If the Prameya Vastu is Atma, yourself, with what can you know yourself? If you become a Prameya Vastu, then you become Anitya. If you become an object for objectification, then you become Anitya. Because the Shariram can be objectified, the Shariram is Anitya. And any external object can be objectified, and we know they are all anitya. And if you yourself can be objectified, then it becomes anitya. Only anitya vastu can be a prameya vastu. Anityams are available for our perception. They are seen. They are available for our objectification. They are drishyam. Therefore, prameyam. Drishyatvat prameyam. Or prameyatvat drishyam. Whereas Atma is Nityaha, which is the knower itself. Therefore, aprameyaha. It is not drishyam. It is drik. And drishyams are subject to change. Therefore, vyabhicharati. Anityaha. Therefore, anityaha. Whereas drik. Drik is changeless. It is kutastha atma. Therefore, nityaha. Therefore, nityasya sharirinaha. Anashinaha aprameyasya. Ime degaha antavantaha. He Bharata. Yudhyasva iti. Then we will read the Bhashyam now. Antavantaha iti.
Antavantaha iti.
Antavantaha.
Antavantaha.
Antaha.
Antaha. Can you all hear me?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Is there any noise? I mean, any audible issue?
No.
Antaha vinashaha.
Antaha vinashaha.
Vidyate.
Vidyate.
Yeshante.
Yeshante.
Antavantaha.
Antavantaha.
Okay. Antavantaha, it is there in the shloka. Bhagavad Pada here gives the meaning. Antavantaha. That antavat is the pratipadikam. Matut pratyaya, tadita pratyaya is used. Asya, asti, that is the, in that sense, tadita pratyaya is adding the tadita pratyaya, you get the form antavat. Anta plus that matut pratyaya, that becomes vatu. Vatu and bat. Therefore, antavat. Antavat is the pratipadika. Antavantaha is Bhagavachan. Antavantavanto antavantaha. So, antavantaha. Antavantaha is antaha. Antaha means end. Antakaha means the destroyer. Lord Yama is called antaka. Because he gives anta to the jiva. The jiva is shariram. He is the Karmapala Data Ishwaraha. So after the Jiva has experienced the karma in the Shariram, he destroys the Shariram. Therefore, it's called Antakaha. Antaha is end. Antaka is Yama, Yamadharma Raja. So Antaha means end. Vinashaha. Vidyate. Asti. Yeshamte. Those which are subject to end, they are called antavantaha. So antavantaha, antaha vanta, two things are there. Antaha is destruction. That which has destruction is antavantaha. They are subject to end. Then the next line. Yatha.
Yatha.
Mrga Trishnika.
Mrga Trishnika.
Mrga Trishnika. It is there. But there is a. Yeah. In the Vashim, Mrga Trishnika. Trishnika. Udakadu is there. Mrga Trishniko Udakadu. It is there. We can repeat after me that. I'll use that word. Mrga Trishnika. Mrga Trishnika. Udakadu. Mrigatrishnika udakadav, not separate. One word. Therefore, Mrigatrishniko udakadav.
Mrigatrishnika
plus udakadav. Ka plus A plus U. Becomes O. Mrigatrishniko udakadav. Mrigatrishnika means mirage. Utaka means water. So mirage, the water in the mirage, that is the meaning. Okay. Mrigatrishniko udakadau. Sadbuddhihi. Anuvritta.
Anuvritta.
Pramana nirupanante. Vichidyate.
Vichidyate.
Sa.
Sa.
Tasyaha antaha.
Tasyaha antaha.
Ime dehaha.
Ime dehaha.
Swapna maya deha divat.
Swapna maya divat.
Deha swapna maya deha divat cha.
Swapna maya
deha divat. Swapna maya deha divat.
Deha divat cha antavantaha.
Antavantaha.
Okay. We'll see the meaning of this line. Yata mrigatrishnikodakado sadbuddhi sadbuddhi anuvritta pramana nirupanante vichidyate sa tasyaha antaha tata ime dehaha swapnamaya dehadivat cha antavantaha. Yata is used. Yata, example is going to come. Therefore, yata, just as mrigatrishnikodakadau. Mrigatrishnika is mirage. Udaka is the water. Mrigatrishnikodakadau. Mirage water. Yata, with regard to the mirage, the water in the mirage, what is there? Sadbuddhihi anuvritta. Buddhi is trilingam, therefore anuvritta. Anuvritta sadbuddhihi. There is a sadbuddhi, anuvritta, connected with, associated with regard to the water in the mirage, there is a sadbuddhi. There is a cognition that the water is there. The presence of water. The water is anuvritta. It is there with regard to the water in the mirage. And is that water real? The water is mirage water. Is it real? Pramana nirupanante. Pramana nirupanante. Pramanaihi nirupanam pramana nirupanam ante. Ante is end. At the end of the analysis, with the means of knowledge, at the end of finalizing with the means of knowledge, examining with the pramana, at the end, what happens? We know that it is mirage water, it is not real. Therefore, what happened to the sadbuddhi? That vichidyate. It disappears. It is removed. The water, what we saw in the mirage, when we saw the mirage water, we thought water is. But when applying, when operating the pramana, then we understood that the water is not there really. Then the sadbuddhi with regard to the water disappears, vichidyate. Saha satasyaha antaha. That is the end of that. So sadbuddhi is not gone away. It goes away. Sadbuddhi goes away. Tata, in the same way, yata tata. Yata mrigatrishnikado sadbuddhi, anuvritta sadbuddhi vichidyate. When pramana, when it is examined and known through the pramana, கன்க்ளூடட் வித் பிரமாணா பிரமாண நிரூபணாந்தே யதா விச்சித்யதே சத்புத்தி அனுவத்தா சத்புத்தி வித் ரிகார்ட் டு மிராஜ் வாட்டர் ததா த சேம் வே இமே தேகாக தீஸ் பாடிஸ் ஸ்வப்னமாயா தேகாதிவத் ஸ்வப்னமாயா தி பாடிஸ் இன் தி ட்ரீம் அண்ட் தி ட்ரீம் அண்ட் மாயா ஸ்வப்னமாயாதி தேகாதிவத் these bodies in the dream and in the maya what it is antavantaha bhavanti this swapna maya degavat ime degaga also it is still subject to end antavantaha bhavati with regard to the mirage water before applying the pramana before applying pramana and coming to conclusion we thought that water is real our cognition was water is and I am very thirsty therefore I thought I can quench my thirst with the water and some people thought water is there a pool of water is there we can take bath therefore sadbuddhi is there therefore the sadbuddhi is there with regard to the mirage water therefore anuvritta sadbuddhi anuvritta means it is continuously associated with the water till we analyzed the mirage water till we understood that water is mithya the mithya mirage water it is considered to be satyam like the raju like the raju sarpa the sarpa seems to be real till we recognize the raju the same way the mirage water also but what happens at the end of the examination pramana nirupanante what happens at the end of our examination with the appropriate means of knowledge then that anuvritta sadbuddhi with regard to the mirga trishnikado it disappears therefore sadbuddhi vichedaha tasyaha antah bhavati so when we understood that water is not there really then that is the anta that is the end of the water in the same way these bodies they are body is it is that existence the satbuddhi is there like what swapna in swapna the bodies which are seen in the dream state they have with regard to that we have the cognition body is but does the body really exist in the dream no it is not similarly in the waking state also it is maya kritam therefore in the waking state also this body is but is that the body really exist it is mithya so therefore with regard to the dream shariram or with regard to the shariram in the jagrat avastha they are not real they are mithya mrigatrishnika udakavat mithya therefore antavantaha ime degaha yatha swapna sharirasya nityattvam nasti tatha eva jagrat sharirasya api therefore both are real both are mithya maya here you can take it as the body with regard which we perceive in the jagrat avastha or we can take the word maya from the vyavaharika point we can take the maya as the individual bodies or we can take the body which is created by the magic that also it can be taken the word maya here swapna maya தேகாதிபத்து. சொப்ன தேகா அண்ட் மாயா தேகா, போத் ஆர் அன்ரியல். இது தென் தி நெக்ஸ்ட் லைன், நித்யஸ்ய
நித்யஸ்ய
ஷரீரிணஹ
ஷரீரிணஹ
ஷரீரவதஹ
ஷரீரவதஹ
அநாஷிணஹ
அநாஷிணஹ
அப்ரமேயஸ்ய
அப்ரமேயஸ்ய
ஆத்மனஹ
ஆத்மனஹ
அந்தவந்தஹ
அந்தவந்தஹ
இதி உக்தாஹ
இதி உக்தாஹ
விவேகிவிஹி
விவேகிவிஹி
இத்யர்த்தஹ
இத்யர்த்தஹ
நித்யஸ்ய ஷரீரிணஹ ஷரீரவதஹ அநாஷிணஹ அப்ரமேயஸ்ய ஆத்மனஹ அந்தவந்தஹ இதி உக்தாஹ விவேகிபிஹி இத்யர்த்தஹ. So here, these bodies, இமே தேகாஹ அந்தவந்தஹ, இமே தேகாஹ அந்தவந்தஹ கிந்து ஆத்மனஹ அந்தஹ நாஸ்தி, ஆத்மனஹ ஆத்மா நித்யஹ அநாஷிணஹ அநாஷி அவிநாஷி அப்ரமேயஹ இதி கே ஞாதவந்தஹ விவேக புருஷாஹ தீர புருஷாஹ விவேகிபிஹி. ஹியர் கர்மணி கர்மணி பிரயோகா, தர்ஃபோர் விவேகிபிஹி. ஷரீரிணஹ ஷரீரிணஹ மீன்ஸ் தட் விச் ஹஸ் எ ஷரீரம், எம்பாடிட் ஆத்மா செல்ஃப் எம்பாடிட் இஸ் கால் ஷரீரிணஹ ஷரீரி ஷரீரவதஹ ஷரீரிணஹ இட் இஸ் த ஸ்லோகா விச் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஷரீரவதஹ. ஒன் ஹூ இஸ் ஹேவிங் பாடி, ஹவு கேன் ஆத்மா ஹேவ் பாடி? As an upadhi, atma cannot be conditioned by the body, conditioned by the upadhi, but it seems to be conditioned, that is the karya of maya. Therefore atmanah upadhi is the shariram, therefore sharirinaha shariravataha, and shariram is subject to destruction, na to atma, therefore anashinaha na nashinaha anashinaha na nashi அநாஷி, தட் இஸ் நஷ்டம் ஷீல ஷீலஹ ஷீலம் அஸ்ய தட் இஸ் நஷ்டம் ஷீலம் எஸ்ய அஸ்தி தட் இஸ் கால் நாஷி ந நாஷி அநாஷி அநாஷினஹ பகுவச்சனம் இட் இஸ் ஏகவச்சனம் அநாஷினஹ இஸ் ஷஷ்டி பக்தி ஏகவச்சனம் அண்ட் தட் இஸ் அப்ரமேய அப்ரமேயஸ்ய தட் விச் இஸ் நாட் எ பிரமேய தட் இஸ் நாட் தி ஆப்ஜெக்ட் ஆஃப் means of knowledge, atmanaha, and they are atmanaha anit atmanaha nityasya anashinaha ime degaha antavantaha iti uktaha kaihi vivekivihi vivekaha asya asti iti viveki. So vivekivihi uktaha vivekivihi uktaha by the viveki it is said what this sharira, this which is the upadhi of atma is antavanta, whereas this shariri, the shariri that which is anashinaha apramayaha that is not subject to destruction iti uttaha kaiki viveki bihi by the viveki purusha, because they know, because they are viveki, they have the knowledge of atma anatma ஆத்மானாத்ம விவேகி விஹி உக்தாக, தே கேன் டிஃபரென்ஷியேட் பிட்வீன் ஆத்மா அண்ட் அனாத்மா, ஸோ தேர்ஃபோர் தே ஹாவ் திஸ் நாலேஜ். ஸோ விவேகா, தேர்ஃபோர் வாட் இஸ் சேட் இஸ் யூ நீட் விவேகா, விவேகா இஸ் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட், விவேக வைராக்யா டே ஆர் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட். ஸோ ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் வித் விவேகா அண்ட் தென் வைராக்யா, இஸ் ஆல் ஆஃப் தி சாதன சதுஷ்டயம். Therefore, Viveki, Vivekam is important, Viveka is important, therefore, Bhagavad Bada says Viveki Vihi, that distinguishing, analyzing between Nitya Nitya, Atma and Atma, that Viveka is important. Only when Viveka is there, Vairagyam will be there. So therefore, it is emphasized here. Then, the next line, Nityasya.
Nityasya.
Anashinaha iti.
Anashinaha iti.
Na punaruktam.
Na punaruktam.
Nityatvasya.
Nityatva,
that Shasti, Nityatvasya, Asya, Nityatvasya.
Nityatvasya.
Dvidha, Dvidhatvad.
Dvidhatvad.
Loke, Nashasya cha.
Loke, Nashasya cha.
So here, yeah, the two words, Nityasya, of the permanent. Nityasya, Shashti Bhakti, and Anashinaha, Anashinaha, that indestructible. They are not Punarukta. Punaha Uktam. Punaha is again. Uktam is told, repeated. They are not repeated. It means what? They are not of the same meaning. So, what Bhagavad Pada says is, in this loke, in this world, that permanence is of two types. Why permanence? Because there are two types of destruction. Therefore, we have to say there are two types of permanency. One is relative, other one is absolute. So when you read, it seems to that Nityasya Anashina seems to have the same meaning. No. Both have the same, the permanence, but that with regard to two types of destruction. So Nityasya Anashinaha Punaruktam Na. Why? Because permanence, Nityatvam is of two types, therefore, the Nityatvam is of two types because the destruction are of two types. What are the destruction? What are the two types of destruction that is being said in the next line? Yatha Degaha.
Yatha Degaha.
Basmi Bhutaha. Adarshanam gataha.
Adarshanam gataha.
Nashtaha ucchyate.
Nashtaha ucchyate.
Vidyamanaha api.
Vidyamanaha api.
Yata degaha, basmi bhutaha degaha, adarshanam gataha, nashtaha ucchyate, vidyamanaha api. Darvya, kama. Then, anyatha. Yadhyadi yuktaha jataha.
Yadhyadi
jataha.
Nashtaha ucchyate.
Nashtaha ucchyate.
Yatha degaha, just as this body, basmi bhutaha. Basmi bhutaha degaha adarshanam gataha nashtaha ucchyate. This degaha, basmi bhutaha, when it dies, becomes ashes. Basmi bhutaha. When it dies, it is cremated, therefore it becomes ashes. When the body dies, it is cremated, therefore it becomes ashes. Therefore, basmi bhutaha degaha. What happened to the previous form? Adarshanam gataha. It disappeared. It disappears. Adarshanam gataha. It attains disappearance. Nashtaha. It is lost. It is gone. Nashtaha. Destroyed. Therefore, it is called destroyed. Basmi bhutaha degaha. Itha. Basmi bhutaha degaha. Adarshanam gataha. Nashtaha ucchyate. When the prana leaves the body is cremated and becomes ashes. And therefore, we say it is destroyed. Therefore, it is destroyed. This is one type of destruction. Destruction of the form of the previous appearance. The previous appearance, body was there. The body was there. Now, body is not there. It is adarshanam gataha. Then, the second type of nasha is there. Vidyamanaha api. I said kama. Kama should come. Nashtaha ucchyate. There. Yatha degaha basmi bhutaha adarshanam gataha nashtaha ucchyate. There we have to stop. Okay. Then the vidyamanasapi starts. That is the next part of the sentence. So kama should not come after vidyamanasapi. கமா சுத்தம் நஷ்டக உச்சதே. எதர் கமா ஆர் வி கேன் புட் அ தண்டா, வி கேன் ஸ்டாப் த சென்டென்ஸ் தர். யதா தேகஹ பஸ்மீபூதஹ அதர்ஷனம் கதஹ நஷ்டஹ உச்சதே. தென் த நெக்ஸ்ட் பார்ட் இஸ் வித்யமானஹ அபி வியாதியுக்தஹ அன்யதா பரிணதஹ நஷ்டஹ ஜாதஹ உச்சதே. திஸ் இஸ் தி செகண்ட் டைப் ஆஃப் டிஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன். வித்யமானஹ அபி ரிமைனிங் அபி, ஈவன் தோ த பாடி த ரிமைன்ஸ், ஈவன் தோ தி பாடி ரிமைன்ஸ், பட் வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ், அன்யதா பரிணதஹ, அன்யதா பரிணதஹ, இட் டிரான்ஸ்ஃபார்ம்ஸ், பரிணாமா சேஞ்சஸ், இட் இஸ் மாடிஃபைட், இட் இஸ் டிரான்ஸ்ஃபார்ம்ட் இன் டு அனதர் ஃபார்ம், இட் இஸ் டிரான்ஸ்ஃபார்ம்ட் இட் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தி டிசீஸ், பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தி வியாதி. வியாதியாதி யுக்தஹ ஷரீரஹ ஷரீரம் பரிணதஹ பரிணதம். ஸோ வியாத்யா பரிணாம த சேஞ்ச் பரிணாம ரூப நாஷா இஸ் டாக்ட் அபவுட். ஒன் இஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் இட் இஸ் துவம்ச நாஷ ரூபா, அண்ட் திஸ் இஸ் பரிணாம நாஷ பரிணாம நாஷ பரிணாம ரூப நாஷ த டிஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன் இன் த ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் தி டிரான்ஸ்ஃபர்மேஷன், பிகாஸ் த பாடி இஸ் டிரான்ஸ்ஃபார்ம் த மாடிஃபை, இட் பிகம்ஸ் இன் இட் ஹஸ் பிகம் இன்கேபபிள், இட் ஹஸ் பிகம் இன்கேபபிள் ஆஃப் கண்டினியூயிங் டு லிவ் ஃபர்தர். தேர்ஃபோர் வியாதியுக்தஹ பரிணத அன்யதா பரிணதஹ, தேர்ஃபோர் வி சே பர்சன் இஸ் நஷ்டஹ, தட் பாடி இஸ் நஷ்டஹ நஷ்டஹ ஜாதஹ இதி. ஸோ பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் த டிசீஸ் ஆர் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தி ஓல்டேஜ் ஆல்சோ வாட் இட் மே பி, தேர்ஃபோர் நஷ்டஹ ஜாதஹ த பாடி இஸ் கன்சிடர்ட் டு பி டெஸ்ட்ராய்ட். The person is as though gone, but still the body is there, the person is alive, but we say the person is gone because there is no possibility of recovery. Therefore parinama rupa nashaha dvamsa rupa nashaha is one, that is the first one, and this is parinama rupa nashaha. Two forms of destruction are possible, one is absolute, other one is relative. The first one is absolute, where the prana has left the body and therefore basmi bhutaha deha, whereas the second one vidyamanaha api ஜாதியுக்தஹ பரிணதஹ ஜாதஹ இதி. தேர்ஃபோர் டூ டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் டிஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன்ஸ் ஆர் தேர், தட் இஸ் பை டூ வேர்ட்ஸ் ஆர் யூஸ்ட் டு இண்டிகேட் தி பர்மனன்ஸ், டு நாக் ஆஃப் தி ரிலேட்டிவ் சென்ஸ் அஸ் வெல் அஸ் டு நாக் ஆஃப் தி பர்மனன்ட் சென்ஸ் ஆஃப் பர்மனன்ட் சென்ஸ் ஆஃப் டிஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன். தேர்ஃபோர் டூ வேர்ட்ஸ் ஆர் யூஸ்ட் நித்யஸ்ய அநாசினஹ, தேர்ஃபோர் தே ஆர் நாட் புனருக்தம், தே ஆர் நாட் ரிபீட்டட் இதி. Bhagavad Pada gives the reason. Okay, so we will stop here. We will continue. We will continue the next line, the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. ஓம் சாந்தி சாந்தி சாந்தி. ஹரிஹ ஓம் ஸ்ரீ குருப்யோ நமஹ. ஹரிஹ ஓம்.
தன்யவாதம்.
தன்யவாதம்.